Hey guys, welcome back to War on Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have a BMW, guys, 7 Series, I'm talking about generation E65, E66, or generation F01, guys, and you're trying to test your purge control valve, guys, this is the purge control solenoid valve stabilizers. We'll explain how to do that. If it's bad, you may experience in, guys, codes such as P0443 or code P0444, guys. And we'll show you guys how to test that thing so you don't have to waste your money and get a new one and know for sure if it's good or bad. Now, that same engine has been used in multiple BMWs. The same purge valve has been used in multiple, guys, BMWs as well. You can find it in 3, 5 series, 7 series, 6 series, guys, X3, X5. So very popular, guys. Doesn't matter if you have a 6-cylinder or 8-cylinder engine, the procedure will be the same. Quick introduction to the channel. Every single car we get at the shop, we make, guys, at least 200 free videos to you, provided to you guys for free. Now, on BMWs, we make close to 400-500 videos. Why? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you guys as much money as we can. So, all we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. If you guys need to buy a new replacement purge valve, we'll have the link in the description of the video below, so please, guys, check it out. Let's explain what the purge valve does, and we'll show you guys, okay, how to test it now. So, things that you're going to need, guys, a little bit of air. I'll recommend air compressor. Don't blow it with your mouth. I'll explain more about that. You need two alligator clips, but let's show you guys, okay, this is the purge control valve, and let's explain what it does. Purge control valve, guys, if you have fuel, okay, gasoline in your fuel tank, what will happen? That gasoline creates pressure, fumes, it evaporates, guys, and when the pressure builds in the fuel tank, there is a sensor that detects that. It tells the car computer that purge valve, control valve, to open and injects the fuel vapors from the fuel tank in the intake manifold of your BMW. But why does that? So the car is more efficient, you do not waste fuel, and you do not kill the atmosphere for emissions mostly, guys. So that's what it does. That valve can fail in two different ways. Make sure you stay with us until the end. I'm going to explain more about that towards the end. And even though if it tests okay, it still may not be good. So I'll explain why. Make sure you stay until the end, guys. Now, the purge valve, guys, it has two wires on the back. One is positive, one is negative. It does not matter where you connect it. You can put the negative on the right or on the left side. But it's very important, guys, not to touch the positive and the negative, because the moment you touch them, that valve will burn, guys, and you will need to buy a new one. So, two alligator clips, we get those because they're super easy to use and they come with the installation, so it minimizes the possibility of damaging it, guys. We'll have the link in the description of the video below. In addition, guys, okay, in addition, what we'll do, we will share if you need to buy a new purge control valve for your 7 series BMW, where you can get it, guys. Now, that valve, when you do not apply 12 volt electricity, it should be closed all the time, guys. When you apply 12 volt supply, I'll recommend to use a car battery, but we'll use the positive terminal on the car. I would not recommend that because you can damage your vehicle, guys. But you will hear the valve open and close. Listen now. Okay. That clicking, that's opening and closing, guys, when we apply 12 volt supply. If we do not apply 12 volt supply, okay, and we apply air on this side, it shouldn't come out of this side. But when we open it, listen now, what's going to happen? So you can see, guys, how it actually moves the paper. What that means? It means that the valve is opening and closing correctly. If it makes the noise, it doesn't mean that it's working. You need to check the airflow. That's why I thought it's very important, because sometimes it may click, but if the valve is broken on the inside, it may not open and closes. And as a result, guys, you will think it's opening and closing, but it's not. Now, something else to look for, even though it may check out all right, make sure that you do not have, guys, broken or damaged O-ring seal right here. Make sure that the pipe is not cracked, broken anywhere, because if it has a crack, the valve will malfunction and you may get a code for vacuum leak as well, guys. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.